They might not be your typical UFOs, but astronomers do occasionally discover unidentified objects floating in the depths of space. Take ORCs, for example. While they might share a name with creatures from fantasy books and tabletop adventures, they are not some kind of weird, scary extraterrestrial. ORC is actually short for Odd Radio Circle, and while we have a few clues to work with, the truth is, we do not know what they are. In the grand scheme of astronomical mysteries, ORCs are pretty new to the scene. As the name suggests, odd radio circles look like circles, and they're visible in the radio band of the electromagnetic spectrum, and they're odd. The first ones were spotted just back in 2019, and as of early 2023, we have only spotted 6 potential ORC candidates. 4 of those candidates are loners, and the other 2 form a sort of double feature, connected by, like, a tail. What's odd about them is that, as far as we know, they are only visible at radio wavelengths. Usually, you see space stuff emitting electromagnetic radiation, otherwise known as light, all over the spectrum. But for some reason, ORCs are stuck in radio, and the reason could actually vary depending on the ORC candidate. For example, one might be an ancient supernova remnant, and that double ORC might just yet be another radio galaxy, a galaxy that just happens to be emitting more radio waves than normal. And the astronomers working on this puzzle don't really consider those to be true ORCs. Because if we set those aside, we are left with 3 ORCs that all have another thing in common. Each have a galaxy smack dab in the middle. Now, that could be a complete coincidence. When we look up into space, all of the 3D universe is flattened into our 2D sky. And that's probably why ORCs look circular, too. They're most likely spherical, or a long horn shape, but both of those look like circles when you see them head on. But the running hypothesis is that these galaxies are the ORCs' point of origin, and there are a few competing hypotheses to explain what these galaxy-encircling objects actually are. One states that they were born of 2 galaxies merging. Not only did all the stars and dust smush together into one big galaxy, the 2 supermassive black holes at their cores did, too. And that merger created a huge explosion and shockwave that extended like a million light years beyond the galaxy. Another proposal states that ORCs are shockwaves created when a galaxy goes through a phase when it starts making a bunch of new stars. All those baby stars create a kind of stellar wind blowing ever outward until something from beyond the galaxy pushes back just enough to stop that wind from expanding. Either way, you get something pretty darn spherical that will look like a circle from way over here. But where do all the radio waves come from? Well, these shockwaves don't just carry a bunch of dust and gas along for the ride. They carry magnetic fields, too. And eventually, those fields are sent crashing into the intergalactic medium, the stuff between galaxies. That collision will accelerate a bunch of electrons out there just minding their own business. Because electrons are charged particles, they will interact with the magnetic fields in a very specific way. They'll start spiraling around and around, emitting a kind of light called synchrotron radiation. Synchrotron radiation can be pretty much any wavelength, but its radio signal is way stronger. In fact, this radiation is one of the dominant sources of radio waves throughout the universe. Meanwhile, the synchrotron radiation emitted at other wavelengths is so weak that we can't really detect those signals from Earth. In other words, ORCs might technically be emitting other kinds of light, we just haven't detected it yet. Researchers are currently analyzing data from an all-sky survey called E-Rosetta to see if they can find these ORCs emitting X-rays. In which case, that would unfortunately make them into, like, ORCsk or, like, OXARC, which isn't as good as ORC, but, you know, either of those. Take them, astronomers. I give those to you. But synchrotron radiation is not the only potential explanation for our mysterious friends. Some researchers claim that ORCs are radio jets shooting out from black holes, big cones of stuff emitting radio waves as they're flung away from the center of the galaxy. We see these sticking out of plenty of galaxies throughout the universe, but they usually point out to the sides. ORCs may be the very special, very rare case when they are pointed exactly directly at us. Other astronomers, though, dismiss this hypothesis on the basis that they're just too darn round. Sure, we have only discovered a handful of these things, but not one is an ellipse. If ORCs are actually just these super long radio jets poking out of the galaxies, the chances are way more likely that our vantage point would be just a little off center. Then we would be discovering not ORCs, but ORES. So these mystery objects are probably a new perspective on some familiar astronomical phenomenon, but that does not mean that there aren't some more novel ideas out there. One duo sitting over in Sci-Fi Hypothesis Corner has suggested that ORCs are the throats of wormholes. That one doesn't seem to be taken very seriously by the broader community, but hey, just wanted to let you know about it, because that's cool. The key to solving any of these mysteries is going to be more data. Looking closely at other wavelengths, looking with even more sophisticated radio telescopes, and looking at the data that we've already got using new models. In time, these astronomical UFOs may finally be identified, and when that happens, maybe they will be a little less odd than astronomers first thought, but maybe they'll be something entirely new. I personally, though, would keep the name either way, at least until we find some actual space orcs. We don't want things to get too confusing. Real-life orcs might be a little too different from your typical fantasy creature to make for good merch, but you know what does? Real-life unicorns. Over at dftba.com/scishow, you can get this adorable sticker set celebrating the one-horned animals of our actual world. And we've even made those horns into rainbows, because who wouldn't want one of those?